Boys and girls, we are learning about living and non-living things, and we have been talking about animals, and we're going to continue to talk about animals. We had some last week and now this morning, and we even talked about non-living, like Joaquin's zoo, but these are living, the ones that we're going to talk about right now. So, hemos hablado muchísimo sobre los seres vivos y los animales. Empezamos con los animales la semana pasada y hoy empezamos también en la mañana por la lectura. Y también hablamos sobre los animales como en el cuento de el zoo de Joaquín, aunque no son animales vivos, pero hablamos de animales y ahora vamos a continuar con la tema. Castores constructores. Por Kathleen Martin James. Castores constructores are building beavers. They're constructing. They are making things. Written by Kathleen Martin James. And in this story, we're going to find out, we're going to figure out what is it that they build and why. So I want you to listen for what do beavers do? Why do they do that? And how do they do it? Okay, so vamos a escuchar qué hacen los castores, por qué lo hacen y cómo lo hacen. Okay. Este animal con pelo húmedo es un castor. ¿Qué crees que está haciendo con todas estas ramas? So this is a beaver. What do you think he's doing with all those sticks? Este castor está construyendo una casa. He's building a home. La casa del castor se llama madriguera. Madriguera. That's his home. It's a den. Una madriguera se hace con ramas de árboles y barros. It's made with trees and mud. ¿Cómo piensas que los castores construyen una madriguera? How do you think they build these? They're also called beaver dams. Primero, los castores cortan los árboles con sus largos y afilados dientes y delanteros. So they start cutting down the trees using their front and very large teeth. ¿De qué color son los dientes de este castor? Anaranjado, very good, orange teeth. Este castor está parado sobre las patas traseras para morder una rama. So he is standing on his back legs in order to bite onto the wood. La cola ancha y aplanada lo ayuda a mantener el equilibrio. So he stands up on his hind legs and uses its tail to help keep balance right here so that he can continue to chew on and chew off that piece of wood. Luego, los castores llevan las ramas y el barro con sus patas delanteras. So later, they start taking the sticks by swimming across with them using their front paws and legs. They also take the mud, ramas y el barro. So they take the sticks and the mud. Pueden construir una madriguera en un arroyo, en un río, o en un lago pequeño. So, boys and girls, they build in different types of water. It can be un arroyo, a stream, en un río, a river, en un lago pequeño, a small lake. A veces los castores construyen un dique en el agua. El agua no puede atravesar un dique. So here's when we hear that word dam, when we say a beaver dam. So the den is their home, and the dam kind of helps block off the water. El agua se hace más profunda a uno de los lados del dique y forma un estanque de castores. En el estanque, los castores construyen su madriguera. So when they build this dam, it helps stop off water. So it can corner up the water, creating almost like a tank effect, kind of like a fish tank where it just kind of pools and sits in one spot. So what they do is they build their den inside that part where the water has pooled up and filled up high. La mayor parte de la madriguera está por encima del agua. Most of the den is on top of the water. ¿Cómo entran los castores? How do they go inside? La entrada a la madriguera está bajo el agua. So the entrance, the way inside, la entrada, is underneath. Los castores son buenos nadadores. Sus patas traseras son palmeadas. So they are very good swimmers and they have palmed-like feet. Los animales de patas palmeadas tienen una piel que une los dedos. So they have a special skin in here between their toes that help move that water the way a paddle would. Las patas palmeadas les sirven para remar en el agua y nadar rápido. So their palmed feet help them swim and go through the water quickly. Cuando un castor nada, la cola lo ayuda a guiar. So their tail works like a guide. It turns and twists. Para qué más usan los castores la cola? So it helps guide them in the water. What else do their tails do? Los castores usan una cola para mantenerse a salvo de los depredadores. It helps them keep safe from other animals that are coming to try to eat them. Los depredadores son animales que cazan y se alimentan de otros animales. So those are predators. So your predator is an animal that comes to eat other animals. Si un castor que está nadando ve o huele un depredador, levanta la cola bien alta. ¿Qué te parece que el castor hará luego? So swimming in the water, and as we see in this picture, when a beaver senses or hears, senses, smells, and hears another animal coming towards them, it lifts its tail high above. What do you think he does with that tail? If you said splash it, yes. Blah! El castor golpea el agua con la cola. He hits the water with his tail. El ruido fuerte avisa a los otros castores que un depredador está cerca. So he's saying that as soon as he makes that really loud sound, yeah, all the other beavers are going to hear it and they will be warned that there's a predator about. Los castores no son depredadores. Ellos son herbívoros. Herbívoros, perdón. So they are not predators. They do not prey on other animals to eat them as food. They eat plants, and we call those, you probably know this word, herbivore. In Spanish, they kind of share the same sound. Herbívoros, herbivores. Solamente comen vegetales. They eat only vegetables. 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 Estas crías de castor están comiendo ramas y hojas. So they're eating branches and leaves. Las crías beben leche de su madre cuando son muy pequeños. So they're like the baby panda, como la panda Huame. They also drink milk. Ellos toman leche del cuerpo de su mamá porque ellos son mamíferos. They're mammals. Mammals have what? What did we say about their blood? Tienen su sangre caliente, ¿verdad? Más con calor que frío. A los castores bebé se los llaman crías. Se les llaman crías. Las crías de castor pueden nadar fuera de su madriguera cuando tienen una semana de vida. So when they are 1 week old, they can swim outside on their own. Boys and girls, this book has a lot of information. So at this point, I'm going to stop the video. And when you're ready to listen to the rest of the story, go ahead and play the next one. Niños, este libro tiene mucha información. Voy a parar el video y cuando estén listos para terminar el cuento, pueden regresar y escuchar la segunda parte. Gracias, niños. Thank you, boys and girls.